And I'm back with Richard Rodriguez talking about his new book of essays, Darling. I want to ask you about essays, the essay form. The typical essay starts with a sentence of a place, sort of a setting, and then winds its way through that setting and far away and comes back. Is that the way? Where do they start?
Well, a lot of my essays start with an idea that's not quite fleshed.
Yeah.
I'm always looking for the fleshy idea because I don't want to simply live at this level of abstraction.
Right.
I want us to be the idea, our contact with each other. In many ways, the essays in this collection are, I like to call them little biographies of an idea, that I show the reader how the idea lives through time, you know,
right.
as I live through time,
right.
how I learned this and didn't and forgot that, and how it came back to me and so forth.
I looked like a couple of examples. The first one, first page, one summer evening in London many years ago, I was walking through green twilight in Hyde Park. Another one later, a 69-year-old body is still beautiful, and then you happen to be in Las Vegas, and it becomes a meditation on Las Vegas.
Yes. The joy for me of writing an essay is that everything is admissible, because that's the way the brain works. And so Elvis Presley's in this book, Muhammad is in this book, Tina Turner is in this book, St. Augustine is in this book, because that the mind is that capacious, and as you think out your existence and you dramatize it in an essay, there are all kinds of people wandering through an essay. That first essay that begins in Hyde Park with a woman asking me, this woman with many coats on, smiling at me and saying, Arabi, she says. And I said, no, this is many years ago.
Right.
And then the discovery of that essay is in the course of writing about Arabia and how it was caricature before September 11th.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
I began to realize that my mother was speaking the name of Allah as... This phrase that she would use in Spanish, "Ojalá," is a phrase that borrows from the Arabic.
Uh-huh.
It's Allah's name is there. "Ojalá," meaning, let's see or let's hope that, and so forth. And there was my mother at the end of this journey, speaking this name of Allah in Sacramento, California, in Spanish. The journey of the mind, that begins with this Arab woman in Hyde Park. No, I don't think I'm an Arab to her, realizing that my mother is speaking. Because Spanish contains within it 3,000 to 4,000 words, which are etymologically Arabic in derivation.
But
that's the surprise.
But if everything is admissible in the essay form, there's a point where the writer...
It becomes madness.
The editor or whoever, maybe it's you doing both, it does become madness. It's too much.
The act of writing is an act of rewriting and rewriting again.
Mm-hmm.
These essays...
These are worked.
These are really worked. and the appearance of disorder is extremely controlled.
Mm-hmm.
You have to, I'm a writer in the age of Steve Jobs, and I'm a writer about religious subjects at an age of growing pessimism and hostility toward religion.
Mm-hmm.
I have to seduce an audience. I have to entertain an audience. I have to tell I have to write stylishly about religion. This book is not a work of excessive piety, I don't think.
Mm-hmm.
It's a work of the mind working, thinking, wondering, being surprised, as I hope the readers.
But you want us to see the working and the surprise, but not all of it, because that would
that's right.
Too much.
That's right. No, obviously it's not. In that sense, it's not a documentary of my mind. It's a fictionalization of the way the mind discovers and learns.
And the essay, of course, has an incredible history of its own,
yes.
right? Going back, which I'm sure you've gone... Have you gone back and you've read essays?
Yeah.
And so where are we? What's its function today?
Well, I'm very skeptical. I think that, as a writer, I require a reader. I'd require you to complete my sentence, that is, to understand it.
Mm-hmm.
And these essays are as entertaining as they might be. They're demanding, and my readers are not large. I mean, there's not a large number of people who can manage this.
Mm-hmm.
Working on the NewsHour many years ago, when we were writing essays, Roger, Anne, and the rest of us, I was struck by the fact that people were so hungry to hear an essay after all of this large news. Here was this solitary voice, sounding, saying, something odd and eccentric and right. individualistic. Mm-hmm. People were listening and absorbing that in some way. Mm-hmm. To this day, people will stop me at O'Hare Airport, usually when I'm running to another gate, mm-hmm. and will say, well, I used to see you on yeah, television. Yeah. Not only that, they remember the idea, the way the idea worked in time. You started saying this, and isn't that's the way the essay works.
Mm-hmm. And well, then let me ask you one last thing back to the book then, because these are individual essays in some sense, right? Some were written. I mean, was it conceived as a whole from the beginning? Would you call it a spiritual autobiography?
No, but I don't call my life a spiritual autobiography right. either. But it is. Right. I didn't know that I would have cancer, which would be chapter three. I didn't know that a friend would die in Las Vegas in the middle of all of this desert right. fantasy. That's chapter four. My friend Darlene, who with whom I have this extraordinary conversation on the day that her divorce is finalized, the book follows the progress, yeah. and then you realize that there are rhythms in a life. There are themes flowing through a life, that these themes of the loss of place, the question of women in the world and in my own life, mm-hmm. It seems to me, the inability of our society to come to terms with death. Which you see now with the green ecology movement, that does not account for the fact that nature is also brown, that there is not only spring in the world, but there is also fall, mm-hmm. and that the fastest growing ecology in the world is the desert. And we keep planting golf courses on the desert, but I'm telling you, we have to come to terms with the fact that nature is more complicated than some television executive or television celebrity saying, be green as she gets on her jet to move to another place.
All right, Darling, a Spiritual Autobiography. Richard Rodriguez, thanks so much.
Thank you, Jeffrey.